Okay, so I'll be teaching you guys how you can save a lot of money on Replit. And bear in mind, this video may be taken down by them because they don't want me to teach you this kind of stuff because it will hurt their overall revenue. But I've been seeing a lot of people in the comment section of my previous video wasting a lot of money on Replit and not actually seeing results. For example, this person spent $120 and the agent circled around for hours and they didn't have any results by the end of it. Someone else said they spent $500 on Replit on their first project and the debugging process drove them crazy. And a lot of other people are saying stuff like they ran out of money using Replit, spending $50 every other day. So honestly, as I said in my previous Replit review video, the agent is not there yet, but I think the rest of the platform is still good when it comes to hosting and stuff, because it solves a lot of the headaches that people may have when it comes to hosting. Firstly, I'm going to talk about why Replit is so expensive, and then teach you the technique that I personally found myself. So firstly, Replit is using the Anthropic models, the Claude models under the hood, which are made by Anthropic, and Anthropic are charging a markup on their API to Replit, who are then charging a markup to you. But Anthropic has also made Claude Code, which is another agentic coding agent, and a lot of people say it's like the best agentic coding agent out there right now. And of course, they don't charge a markup to themselves because Claude Code is made by Anthropic, and then they charge a tiny markup to you, but this is actually in the form of a subscription with rate limits. So when you're using Claude Code, you either use a $20 a month plan or the $100 a month plan or the $200 a month plan. And this is significantly cheaper than Replit because I showed in my previous Replit video, where I was paying for the $200 a month plan with Claude Code and got $3,000 of usage out of the $200 a month plan. And if I was doing all of that on Replit, then I would probably end up spending over $3,000 on Replit. And that's because Anthropic can just serve their own model to themselves in their own products for cheaper than Replit is able to. And another big reason is that a lot of these vibe coding startups like Replit, Lovable, Bolt, and so forth, they've hit insane amounts of revenue growth, such as like in this case, Replit is over here. And I have the screenshot because one of the investors in Replit like showed this on Twitter. And what actually happens is even though they've hit like $150 million of annual recurring revenue, a lot of this, like about like 90-95% of this, is going to Anthropic actually, because they have to pay the model provider that's powering their agent because they don't actually have their own coding agent themselves. And the exact same thing applies for Lovable, Bolt, and other vibe coding tools. They say they reached $100 million in annual recurring revenue, but they're not actually making profit because like $99 million of those dollars is actually going to Anthropic, which is powering their models. So Anthropic is a real winner here, so you might as well use an Anthropic model through their own coding agent. And as a short aside, we've been seeing industry shift where Cursor and also Windsurf have now actually come out with their own models that they train themselves or fine-tuned other models of. And that's significantly cheaper to run as well, because like the person who actually made a model will always be able to run their own model for the cheapest. So now that I've actually explained that context, what you can do is you can actually use Claude Code within Replit itself. And this is actually a technique that I shared about a month ago on my AI startup school. And I share a lot of techniques like this. There will be a link down below if you're interested in joining it. A lot of people have already joined before, learned to vibe code and market their own applications, and then reached pretty big revenue milestones with applications. So you may also find it useful. Anyways, as for the technique, it involves installing Claude Code within Replit. So you want to go to Claude Code website. It will also be linked down below. And you want to copy over this command that you can see. So when it says copied, you have it in your clipboard, and then you want to go to your Replit project. So for example, this is a project that I was making a month ago with Replit to test it out, and I was really struggling with this project because like the agent is just not as good, and they don't care if you spend a lot of money on it because it just means more revenue for them, and it means they'll like raise even more money. But like I care about saving you guys money, so this is like a much better approach. So with that command, you want to press plus tools and files, and then go to shell over here. And this will basically open up a shell in the project that you're running on Replit. And you can see that this works properly because you can write in something like ls. And you will basically see all the files that exist on the right-hand side, like client, server, drizzle, config, ts, in this list as well. So like this is a terminal that's running within the same directory that you have your Replit files in. And you want to run the command to install Claude Code that you copied earlier. So then press enter. And then it will ask you for a theme, so choose dark mode. And then it will ask you to sign in. So the Claude account, if you're using Claude Code, requires a subscription. And the subscription is $20 a month on the lowest tier, but you do get some good usage out of it. And then $100 a month if you want to upgrade to the high tiers. But I would recommend starting off with the $20 a month tier. So you like go and make your Claude Code account. For me, I'm currently on the $100 a month tier and I find that to be sufficient. But many people find the $20 a month tier to be sufficient. And like I mentioned earlier, this is significantly cheaper than actually using Replit because like Anthropic on the model itself. So anyways, where it says select login method, press enter, with cloud account with subscription. And then it will open a brand new tab on your computer. So even though it's opened a new tab for us, we actually want to click on this URL instead. So we want to ignore the new tab, close that new tab, click on this URL, and then it will open it up in a new tab for us, and then press authorize. And then you should see something like this. So it says paste this code into cloud code, copy, go back to the Replit tab, paste this in here, and then press enter. So of course your code will be different from my code. And now I'm signing into my like account and then press enter. So I'll be logged in as this account, press enter. And now it will say, do you trust the files in this folder? Yes, proceed. And then I can finally use cloud code within Replit. So using my tool Hyperwhisper, I'm gonna basically say, hey, so what is this project about? Like, can you break it down for me? And that will transcribe what I just said. So there will be a link to that down below in the description, my Hyperwhisper tool. And now it will actually look through all the projects files and figure out what the project is about. So you can see that's now reading through the files. And whilst we're waiting on that, let me go back to the preview thing. So I actually want Cloud Code to make an edit to this design because I don't think the design here is like very good. So you can see it told me what the project is about. And I'm going to switch to planning mode here. So press Shift Tab to switch to planning mode and then say, can you come up with a brand new design for the landing page for me? Add a pricing card as well that has like a placeholder. And now it's pasted what I just said, so I can press enter. And then it will basically figure out a plan for how this should be implemented. And now whilst we're waiting, it is worth mentioning that I have a Cloud Code Masterclass that teaches you every single thing you need to know about Cloud Code. So like I go through every single feature, and basically if you don't like the class, then you can get a 7-day money-back guarantee. And the reason I made this is because like people really love Cloud Code, but a lot of people were having a hard time getting started because all the information is scattered across different videos on the internet. I also do cover some bonus content as well that I haven't covered before on this YouTube channel. Anyways, you can see that Cloud Code has come up with some questions for us. So we can say, creative and playful for the design. So let me press down. I'm going to have free tiers. So let's have a free basic pro enterprise. And then it will be like monthly and yearly plans. And what sections should we have? So we have a hero section. We have a feature section. Let's have some FAQ as well. And then press submit. And then Cloud Code will think for a bit and then come up with this plan for us. So this is a plan that I came up with. So let's press auto accept edits, but actually let's pause it by pressing exit and switch the model to a faster model. So currently we were using Sonnet 4.5. Let's switch to Haiku because it's like much faster because I want the video to be filmed faster. And you also won't hit into your rate limits quite as much when using this model. And then I'm just going to say continue, press enter. So it's currently still underway. So it says, can I run npm run check? And I'll say yes and don't ask again, press enter. And it will actually make a .cloud folder for itself, which has the settings. So if I click on this folder, I can see this is like the permissions that it allows itself to use. And you can do all the same things that you can do with Cloud Code. So you can like make a cloud.md, press enter, and then I can basically write my own cloud.md. But anyway, it will quickly run the build command to check that everything works properly. And literally the advantage here is that we're not paying as we go. We're saving on so much more money. So it says it's now done. So I can go back to preview. And this is a design that I came up with. So this is like quite nice. It has a pricing section that we had earlier. It has this like flip button too. So this looks better, I think. Page is quite small. Let me open it up in a brand new page here. And then it will look nicer on a bigger screen. Anyways, this is what it looks like now. I should have got it to like move the upload your images to a different section or something like that. And then we can basically press publish to then publish this project online. So I'm going to call it AI Startup School Nano Portrait. And then press publish. And that will basically trigger the build command for us and then publish this project online. And the reason I shared this particular technique is because I don't think the Replit agent is any good or cost effective. And I think Cloud Code, which actually made the model that Replit is using behind the scenes, have made a much better agentic experience and a much better agent itself. Like I use Cloud Code literally every single day. But I do think the Replit like infrastructure is quite good because like you can just publish a project. It has a database and a couple other things. Like they have built out some pretty good infrastructure when it comes to hosting your projects. And it seems that our project is now published, so I can go to this URL here. And it will open up in a new tab. And this is basically the design improvements that Cloud Code made to our project. And if you want to rewind any changes because it did something like crazy or wrong, then you can just do slash rewind. And then I can go back to any early point. So for example, if I go back to this point, it will say, do I want to restore the code and conversation, restore the conversation, or just restore the code? And yeah, I'll just do nevermind instead and then press exit. And now I'll exit out of Cloud Code by doing slash exit here. And then if I want to run it again, I can just run Claude, and then it will launch Claude code one more time. Anyways, I hope you found this video useful. Do like the video and subscribe to the channel because it lets YouTube know that this is a good video, and then we can help other people save money on Replit as well. And if you do want to learn more about Claude code, then I cover a lot to do with that in my Claude code masterclass that's linked down below with a coupon code. And if you do want to learn more about how you can make money from vibe coding applications, I do cover a lot to do with that in my AI startup skill that's linked down below.